So early on, you explained why it's important to have good pet food and everything. So of all the brands, why switch to Maxime pet food?
Well, I know it's really, this is my job. The reason why I think there is definitely an excellent option for you to feed Maxime by feeding Maxime is because we know what drives the quality of the feeding for cats and dogs, and also you as an owner. I cannot insist enough on the food safety. Some companies don't care about that. They say it's dry food, it's for a dog or cat. There is no risk. I tell you, when you open the bag, you touch the food yourself. And when you put the food and you give it to your dog or cat, your kids touch the food. And if you have contamination in the food, there is a significant risk for the food safety and the health of cats, dogs, and also for humans. So food safety is definitely the critical point. Yes. Second, the taste. A dog or a cat start eating by the smell. They smell, then they eat. So we want the food to be very attractive, to make sure they eat the best meal after meal. And of course, another point is make sure that the digestive tract is good and the poops are small, not smelly, and of good quality.
Yes, of course, we love our pets. And how do we show love to our pets? By giving them only the best. All right, okay, my next question would be, what are the specific ingredients that we should look out for when we're out buying food for our pets?
The first thing I would check is making sure you have real meat inside the food, real protein source. It can be dehydrated or fresh. I don't worry too much about that, but look at the protein source. Make sure you have real meat inside. Make sure you don't have too many ingredients. And of course, make sure that what you read on the bag is found on the ingredient list. There is no trick. If you can follow this, you know it's a good food.
I'm sure you can comment sa ato maningala mga gutama, no? Sige, kakasakit ang atong pets. Ang ato man itinapakaon sa ila, kaya dili siya tinuon ng mga ingredients. These are not like what doctor said,
real meats,
which is very important and it's part of the ingredients in the pet food that we're going to give to our beloved pets. Okay, my last question for you. What would be the best way to introduce a new diet to my dog or cat?
I get the question. When you need to introduce the food to your pet, a new food, you must do a food transition, both for dogs or cats. Never change suddenly, because you will have two issues. Maybe the food will be rejected, your dog or your cat may not like it, especially cats. And the second, they may have diarrhea. So let's try to avoid it by doing a food transition, 25-75, 2 days, 50-50, 2 days, 75-25, and then the final. Except one Maxime salmon and tuna can be switched whenever you want. When the cat eats one of them, you can switch from one diet to another one without a food transition. But remember, food transition is key.
All right, so we also have to be a little patient when it comes to introducing something new sa ato mga pets. We take the time to introduce new food, especially when we're going into something that's much better than what we're used to giving our pets.
We all have our preferences. Some people, okay, I come from France. I love Dorian. Most of my friends don't like it, but it's a personal preference. There is always a food that your dog will prefer or cat will prefer rather than another one. Sometimes there is no choice. Your dog or your cat is the boss.
Cat is the boss. I was very interested in that when you were giving out the presentation. That is actually very, very true. Ang cats mangod, no? Sila yun ang mapuot sa ato. Dili kita ang tagiya sa cat. Sila ang nakatagiya sa ato. Sila ang ato mga boss. And that's very, very true. So a big hand, please, for Doc. Thank you so much for that very insightful presentation.
Ask me questions.
Doctor, if there are questions from the audience, would you be open for them to come and visit you at the booth? We do have another speaker for today. Ladies and gentlemen, we're so happy to have you here once more. Happy Higalahay sa inyong tanan. Yan, okay. So, padayong na. Alright? We do have very, very knowledgeable guests here sa atong Petpalooza. Our next one is a veterinarian specializing in small animals, surgery, and feline medicine. Active in spay or neuter programs and animal welfare policy. Published researcher on feline diseases in tigers. Ladies and gentlemen, please help me welcome feline practitioner Dr. Kino Ian Moralde.
So let's talk about cats, of course, my favorite breed, Puspins, of course. So I think there's a lot of cat owners here, no? So let me talk about cats. As you can see here, these are my fur babies actually. They're all rescued cats, Puspins actually. Those are my cats. Those are my roommates. Ako kaoban matulog every night, pagising, and I used to have 9 cats, and then I have 8 now. So these are my cats, so of course I'm proud of my cats here. So for the diet part, I think Doc already mentioned everything about nutrition, no? So what I can add with cats is you have to make sure that the water and the food are not together. So kana mga inig mo doon, hindi sila same sa dogs na gusto ang water and food tapal. So if you have cats na who doesn't want to drink water much, maybe because tapal ang food sa water, so hindi gusto ang cat ana. And then nakita mo mga dogs usually, if itapat niyo ang food and water, gaanto ang iring sa CR or sa planggana, and then ang owners, i-close the CR para mag-inom ang iring sa water. Bowl, no? So, may tapuan na mag-utilize sila kay the water source, supposedly ang CR, close na ninyo. So, what you have to do actually is you have to provide bigger containers for the cats to drink. As mentioned daw kanina, no, pwede mo mag-water fountains, but i-check sa kung diling mahadlok ang iring. Like my cats here, no, hindi sila pwede sa water fountain, kay once mag-start na mag-bloom ng water, mahadlok sila. So, there are cats who like water fountains, there are cats na din ko gusto. Personally, what I use is a stainless bowl. Nakotun siya. Muna rice cooker ang size. Inalaan ko siya sa iling. So, when you give your cats water or a container for water, make sure ang face nila, makita nila ang ilang face when they drink. Makita nila ang face, makita nila ang background sa likod. That's the only times na ang iling water. So that's the answer kung ano ang iring pinupato sa CR, sa balde, sa plangana. Kaya baka gawin lang kayo yung water bowl. So you have to make sure you have to change the size of the water. So that's the only part for the diet. Don't discuss it with Dr. Nan, Marina. And then another thing, you have to make sure that the reason with Dr. Nan, no, is the... Another thing is the protein source. So as mentioned kanina, you have to make sure the cat food you're giving is into the protein source. You can actually see it at the ingredients, no? Na ay mga protein source dito. Kabutang kung asa dyan siya dito, chicken, bone meal, specific food source. Dili na trimmings or napoy mga plant-based, no? And another thing, make sure you give proper vitamins. There are cat food like Elite Cat Food Maxi or other brands na premium na anay vitamins sa cat food, no? Because for cat owners here, I'm sure my experience nyo, nilisod kayo katala ng vitamins sa iring. Especially medicines, no? Nilisod kayo na siya. Personally, I have 8 cats. Vet pa ko. Nilisod lang yaman ko katala. So it's the cats actually, no? So what I advise, at early age, na makikita ka ron, itry halina na always everyday ang mouth, ang gums, para maanag na sila. Hindi na sila masyadong ay tambal, ay medicine, or you have to give regular vitamins doon para hindi sila masyad pag-medicine na. Hindi mo mag-lisod hatal. Also, you have to limit tuna and salmon na for humans. There are tuna salmon proteins for cats. There are tuna and salmon for humans. Hindi sila pwede mag-mix. So mga kalagahan na kung tuna, century tuna, 555 sa baba na, hindi pwede ang tuna sa cats na pan-humans. Why? They will develop hepatic hepatosis or liver problems. Masyadong maging fatty ang liver with the tuna for humans at lahat ng mga. Or actually, in the wild bangon, wala doing fish source ang domestic cats or our wild cats ng mga tigers. Wala may isda dito sa, like lions, no? Hindi pa ka makita ang isda dito sa desert. So what they eat usually is meat. They are obligate carnivores. So you have to provide protein source na animal based. So take note, no, for, we have vegetarians here. Hindi pwede ang plant-based sa cats. You have to make sure it's animal-based protein or you will have problems in the long run. So that's also the reason why hindi po advisable ang liver food like canton. Because like I've said, they are obligate carnivores. I think na-mention din ang difference sa cats and the dogs. If they are obligate carnivores, you have to make sure the protein are coming from animals. Then taas dun ang protein source sa cats. So, pagiging carnivore sila. Oh, I mentioned about the water already, no? So, cat litter. So, for cat litter po, I have 8 cats sa room. What I use is 120 liters na mega box. And I clean it twice a day. Important na, no? It's like ikaw, magulang ikaw, kung mag-CR ka, then kung gisundan, wala nag-flash, di mo muraglahin tayo. Hindi siya enticing na ito, no? So you have to clean your cat litter twice a day, at least, no? If you can do it more, mas better. Pero like me, syempre, when I wake up, I clean everything, the cat litter, the floor. Mahimula na ako na twice a day, if I have to go to work, may mabalik na po. So I use a bigger litter box. Just to make sure na hindi siya mapuno by the time na muli ko sa, ano, sa gabi na minsan, no? So if you are busy and you don't have much time, you really have to invest with bigger litter boxes or more litter boxes depending sa cats. Usually the rule is if you use the small litter boxes, ito lang ginabaligya. The rule is 2 plus 1, 1 plus 2 actually. So it's 2 plus 1. If you have 2 cats, it's 1 litter box. If you have 3, 1 and 1. Basta 2 cats, 1 litter box. So 4 cats, 2 litter boxes na, and so on, no? If gamay ang gamit. And then, make sure kung hindi rin kaya ang gamay, na hindi rin kaya ang dagan na litter box, you have a very big litter box. So make sure na pag nagamit ang everyone, hindi pa siya mapuno. So the problem with big litter boxes, though, of course, kabalo ko animal, mahal kayo ang cat litter. You really have to put at least 20 liters of cat litter, diha? Hindi siya pwede mo na ako 10 liters. 1 inch dapat ang sa kapal ng cat litter when you look at it sa litter box. So that's my, on the cat litter. Kaya there are questions actually na, Dok, ano ang ilig na ko dilimangi sa cat litter box? Ano, malibang sa bed. So you have to check your cat litter box, baka na ay problem. And then there are cat litter materials also na humot kayo sa tuwa, hindi na siya pwede sa ilig. Then when you pour your cat litter, I know there are a lot of cat litters na barato karon, no? But you have to check, when you pour the cat litters, kanang dust na mumulupan, yung dust di kaayo, pwede na siya musulog sa, of course, sa lungs sa ilig. So when they use cat litters, it's a very close contact sa lungs, no? Kaya mag-over man sila. Makita ninyo, ganun na yung dust galupan. You have to stop using those cat litters kasi it can affect the lungs in the long run. And there are cats na hindi gusto mo gamit po. So actually, if you're a cat owner, you really have to check the behavior of your cats. So, kumusta sila, no? Especially if you have, I have 8 cats. Memorize na ko ang behavior sa 8. So, kabalo ko na yung problem. Slight change in behavior, na yung problem ang ilig. So, habits, habits of cats, no? Like I've said kanina, if you're a cat owner, it's not like dogs no good, they tend to form a pack. They usually move in sync, no, ang dogs. Gusto sa isa, the following one. Ang cats no good, if you have 5 cats, you have 5 different cats dun. Hindi sila mimic o ano. They have different attitudes, they're unique, individually. So you have to memorize kung saan gusto nila, asa sila gusto magpaon, asa nila gusto mag-sleep. You have to memorize all those things, no, because once you're a cat owner, you have to remember, if you know the habits of your cats, we doctors or veterinarians, we can diagnose the problem faster. Okay? Ang first question you have when you bring your cats to me is, what changed? So, na ba siya sleeping habits na nag-change? Are there cat behaviors na nag-change lately? Kung ang iringi mo usually matulog sa bed, and then in a time, then lately, sa floor na siya, it means there's a problem. Any change in behavior, actually, you have to watch out for that. Because cats are habitual animals. When I say habitual animals, they do the same thing every day. So if you're a cat owner, tutugtog sa'yo kong iring, kabalujud ka ang habit sa'yo kong iring, mas hinitayin mo na, mag-memorize mo na, na this time ang iring na-delay, this time ang iring na-delay, by this time, gadula ako iring. You have to memorize those things. Kaya once mag-change na siya, you have to ask yourself, nano nag-change? Kaya baka na yung problem. Kaya usually, especially male cats, no, neutered or not neutered, pag nag-change ang behavior nila, ang next ana, UTI na lang. That's the first sign na mag-change. So of course, you also need grooming. Kani ginaas isa ko ako, Luis, no? How many times do you need to bath your cat? So actually, as a veterinarian and owner of 8 cats, I don't bath my cats. They stay indoors, they are ospids, so they don't need a bath. They groom themselves. Actually, when kanatawin yung iring, diba, i-hug niyo sila, i-kiss niyo sila, then mag-groom sila. It's because they don't like your smell. So, ginabalik mo lang nila smell, no? So, if you bat them always, stressful kayo for the cats. So, for those cats na short-haired and then indoor, you don't actually need to give them a bath. But, for those Persian cats or long-haired, you have to give them once a week. And then, ang combing nila is dapat every day. Hindi rin pwede mag-skip. Kaya once automatic na siya, if you have groomers, we have a lot of groomers here in CDO already. You please do not let your groomers demat your cat. Sakit kayo na. That's the reason na ang cats, di rin na mas bumalik sa groomer. Because there are owners mong good gaingon na ayaw lang ikalbo, i-demat lang. Please do not allow na mag-demat ng iringi, sakit kayo na siya. Nagpawin na siya, hinahila ang inyong buhok ang doon mag-straight balik. So, please do not do that to your cats. That's the main reason actually na ang cats, matroma sila sa grooming. It's the demanding part. So, what I actually advise, if it is matted, it has to be removed. So, bakit pa po, dinimove mo patches. So, mas dito, dinimove na lang tanan, di ba? Para pantay mo siya. So, that is the grooming part. For the veterinary visits, this is another very common question. When do you need to deworm your cats? Actually, there are dewormers that you can give at 3 days old. So, 3 days old. Then you have to make sure the mother cats are dewormed. There are a lot of worms na pwede mo agi sa milk kung sa kittens. That's the reason na kittens na worms early as 1 day old, no? Because the moment they start breastfeeding, nai-worm sa mommy, mapasa siya sa kittens. So you have to deworm them early as 3 days. And vaccination usually starts at 8 weeks old, 2 months. So you have to make sure you have to give vaccines now. We have feline panleukopenia, so we have a lot of cat owners here. No, I think I experienced that cat parvo, you know, it's very traumatic. Once cat parvo enters your home or your vicinity, it kills the cats very fast. So I think 2018, I experienced this. We used to rescue. Actually, sa una, the rescue jud me because a lot of cats. When Palikopin na hit the cattery, we had one cat vomited, I think, 8 a.m. Then namatay siya night. Then namatay siya tanan. Na siya kapaspas, no? So this is actually not something na, ano, no? I know the rescue today. The mahal dyan ang vaccine, but you really have to give, you have to invest in vaccinations kasi sayang yung effort once parvo comes in. Kaya unlike parvo sa ilo, they only hit puppies up to 11, 12 months old. Ang cats mango, they hit, the parvo hits all ages. So maski 5 years old na yung clinic or 2 months old, paspas ang parvo ng patay ng cats, especially if they are not vaccinated. Okay? So, rabies vaccine, of course, this is another confusion, no? Okay, the dog owners, sabi nila, vaccination will start 3 months. Actually, vaccination for anti-rabies starts 3 months. Dili ang cat and dog vaccine. Kaya ang dog vaccine karon, I think there are as early as 4 weeks old na inaatag for parvo and distemper. Cats are 8 weeks old. Ang anti-rabies ang 3 months old or 12 weeks old. So, please remember that. Ang anti-rabies na inaatag 3 months old, dili ang core vaccines. Another vet visit is the, of course, if you have indoor-outdoor cats, which is also common, no? The ticks and the fleas actually for cats, the fleas and mites sa cats, you have to give prevention for that also. Because they also have cat dengue or Lino Bartonella, he can sa fleas. So, munaon ang platelet and then dili mukhaon ang ilig. So, that's the reason why you have medications for 21 days, 28 days. So, that's actually cat dengue. And you have to invest sa pre-prevention for this. So we have spot on for cats now, nanay dewormer, nanay flea preventions. You can ask your vets for that. And then of course, my personal favorite and my advocacy, neutering. So when can we neuter our cats? Sa una, neutering sa cats actually and dogs is 6 months old. But then in my experience, magod na ay 4 months cat na mabunos na. So by that time, 6 months na sila, nanganak na sila. So late na kayo na, no? So I checked with international references the 4 months na dun sila. So the neutering for female cats are 4 months old. Hindi mo gusto mo dagan sila. Kaya once mag-uwag na sila at mabulos na sila, they will not stop getting pregnant. Because for dogs kasi, they have, ang dogs magod, kung ano yung dogs mo, no? They have cycles, regla at low. So na is spotting, na is that. Ang cats dili. Ang cats, once they mature, na ay male cats, continuous na hindi na basta. So maski, karang mga owners na ganyan, na ay hindi man yung mabulos ako, iring kay kapatiyan pa. No, that is not a limit for cats. Cats will go and mate, maski yung kapatiyan pa na sila. So you will have cats giving birth every 2.5 months. So imagine na, dagan kaya na sila. Dagan na sila very fast. And then, ang kittens na po nila mag 4 months, bahay, so makalat na po. So imagine ang rate ng cats na, ang ano siya, exponential siya, no? If you have 2 cats, and then, ipasagdan mo mga nakupat, na ay 2 ka female. So na after 6 months, nabulos ang mami, nabulos mo ng 2 ka anak. So you have 3 pregnant cats. So you will have a problem in population, no? So you have to neuter your cats. 4 months ang female. For the male cats, 6 months actually ang recommended. Then you can actually wait for longer years for the male cats to develop. Kaya mga owners na gusto mo ako ang tom cats, so when I say tom cats, these are cats, mature male cats na dako ang naong. Kung gusto ninyo mo dako ang naong sa iting, kaya dako dyan, pwede ninyo i-neuter later on na. Just be prepared for the indoor cats, no? The male cats will sprinkle urine. Territorial marking na sila, okay na siya. Because I tried